Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm going to start out using the L'Oreal Skin Perfection Pore Vanishing Cream. It basically just fills in any pores, helps to smooth out wrinkles, and obviously primes for anything that will be placed on top of it, which will be the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation. I've been raving about this recently. It is the bomb. It's just like really full coverage, but it doesn't look cakey, it doesn't look thick and like masky. It just feels really light on the skin, but it covers everything. Wow. For concealer, I'm using the Stila Aquaglow Concealer underneath my eyes to highlight mainly and also to conceal a little bit. I don't like to apply too much foundation underneath the eyes because I know that I will always go in with a concealer afterwards and I don't want it to be too cakey. Then, for the first time ever on my channel, I think, I'm using the Laura Mercier Contour Palette, the first shade, Contour 1, to contour my cheeks. I don't know why I never like contour with creams. I think I just prefer the versatility of using a powder, and it also is a little bit more forgiving in my opinion, but I did like how this turned out. It is fun to try different techniques that you don't often try, and people have been telling me to try contouring with creams, so here it is guys, here it is. I also tried to contour my nose, but I feel like that was kind of unnecessary because I already had quite a narrow bridge, so it just kind of looked a little bit weird. And then I contoured my forehead and temples just to minimize the whole, you know, size of the forehead, as we all know, and that worked out really well as well. And I'm just blending it out with a slightly fluffier brush and then just pointlessly contouring my nose. Next, I'm using this MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in Light What's New to highlight my under eyes, just to set that in place. I know there's the whole baking trend that everyone's doing right now, but I feel like it's so wasteful. Like, I feel like I'm just wasting the powder, and I'm such like a stinge when it comes to things like that. But I will try it one day. Next, I'm just shocked at how much my eyelids have creased. That is crazy. Anyway, I'm just setting that in place, and then I'm going to follow up with face powder, which is by Makeup Store, and it is the HD powder. And of course, I'm just applying that all over my face to set my foundation. I am just obsessed with matte skin, matte feeling skin more so. I don't really care about how it looks in terms of matte or dewy. I just like the feeling of matte skin. I hate touching my face and it feeling sticky or tacky. So that's pretty much why I powder. And then I go straight back in and add artificial glow, which is the best way to go in my opinion, unless you have beautiful flawless skin that can pull off the dewiness, which I don't think I have. Anyway, I'm going to apply the Coralie Stuff by Benefit Box Blush. This stuff is amazing. I'm obsessed with it right now. It adds a beautiful sheen to the skin. None of my other blushes have this kind of sheen. It's hard to explain, but it's really, really nice and really makes the skin look fresh and glowy. Next, I'm using Champagne Pop by Becca quite heavily on the highest points of my face, so my cheekbones, my eyebrow bone, my brow bone, my nose, Cupid's bow, all those lovely places. What a weird thing to say, lovely places. Because I try to record these voiceovers in large chunks, I feel like there's pressure to keep on talking, so I just make up stuff that doesn't even make sense, like just then. Anyway, now I'm using the Chi Chi Brow Pomade in Taupe to fill in my eyebrows. And this is a brush by Dose of Colors. I just got a parcel from them recently, and I've been trying out the brushes during this video, and they're all really, really nice, especially this one. I love that you've got the little spoolie on the end of the brush, as well as the eyebrow brush itself. And don't even get me started on this brow product. I am obsessed. It is amazing. Love, 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 love. And it's the best brow pomade that I've tried thus far. So yes, loving it. Then I'm going to use the Makeup Store Brow Trio, the first shade, just to kind of go over that, just to fill in any little gaps, and to add that kind of softness that only like an eyeshadow powder can give you, in my humble opinion. And then I'm going to go in with the L'Oreal Brow Artist Plumper Clear Brow Gel to set them in place. Now I'm using this incredible Natasha Denona palette. These, oh my gosh, they're expensive, but if you have the budget or if you're saving up for some kind of eyeshadow powder, sorry, eyeshadow palette, these are, oh wow, amazing. Just like probably one of the best eyeshadows I've ever really tried. They're just beautiful and the shades you get are stunning. Anyway, I will leave all of the shades that I used in the description box because I know you can't really see them when I'm showing you in this video, but I'm basically just blending like crazy, quite high, like quite blown out towards my eyebrow just to make it really, really, really smoky, using some nice warm, warm browns in the crease as a transition color. and then going in with this ColourPop cream shadow, which I thought was more of a green, but obviously not, and applying that on the lid and blending it out with a synthetic brush into the crease, and then going in with a kind of dark foresty green just on the eyelid with my finger to pack on the product tongue twister, and then blending that out even further into the crease. Just blend like crazy. I was blending for years during this video. I was just blending. Then I'm going to go in with still blending. Yes, I probably should edit that down a little bit, but anyway, I'm using a pencil brush to blend in the inner corners to bring that down, just to make it all seamless. I didn't add any product to the brush, I just simply blended what was already there, and I'm blending some more. Then I'm going to blend that underneath the lower lash line as well, basically the same colours that we used on top, just to smoke it out like crazy. I never really mentioned the brushes that I use, but if you guys would like me to start, then I will. Just let me know in the comments section. Yes, don't know what that was. And then little Mimi, look at her. Oh, she just had to make a little cameo. Oh. Anyway, now I'm using this kind of gold glittery shade in the center of the eyelids and patting it all over the eyelids. Just adds a bit more dimension, a bit more interest. And we all know I love a little bit of sparkle here and there. Then I'm using this Urban Decay Waterline pencil. This green shade is actually more pigmented than the black shade, which I find really odd, but nonetheless, worked perfectly in this look. Perfect shade for it, adds a bit of darkness, but not too dark, and matches in with the green that we used on top. Now I'm going to go in with mascara. This one is actually quite thick in its consistency, so if you don't like clumpy mascaras, you may not like this one. But I just like it because it really coats the lashes, especially before falsies, which we'll go on next. These are the Red Cherry 48s. Quite spidery, but that's kind of my thing. Just sticking them straight on. Then I tried this beautiful shade from Dose of Colours, and I lost my marbles, and amazing, love it. Did not think I would like it this much. It actually dried quite dark, but I still loved it. But I felt like it needed to be applied with a lip pencil, which is fine, just means it takes a little bit longer, requires an extra tool. But for the most part, obsessed. I hope you guys like this look. I love how it turned out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye!